big day today. Finance Minister Arun Jaitley will be presenting his first budget today. He has gone in to meet the President. It is the inaugural budget of the Narendra Modi government, and huge expectations that it will unveil bold reforms in a bid to turn around the economy. At the same time, it may take some tough decisions as well. The Prime Minister has already warned that a bitter medicine is needed for the Indian economy. Well, let's go across to our reporters who join us with guests on what they expect from the budget. Let's go across to Monideepa. She's joined with the Millennium Mams. These are housewives who track the stock market, and the stock market hasn't been doing too well, Monideepa, over the last 2 days. But over to you on what they expect.
Let me talk right away to the ladies who are here. Sirisha, let me ask you, are you expecting a bitter pill that everybody is talking about? Are you expecting the stock markets to do better after Mr. Jaitley finishes his speech?
Well, let me put it in this way. 5 years ago, I heard India superpower. For 5 years, I didn't hear that word. I only heard negative about it. So after this budget, I definitely expect, bitter pill or not, I expect tomorrow's headlines to scream that yes, India is back on track and is here to stay for a long, long time. Let them do that, whatever it takes.
You expect it, but are you going to get it?
Yes, we are going to get it. I'm very positive about that.
Stock markets, will they go up or down, Sunanda?
To me, that's quite irrelevant because that is just a momentary feature. Long term, I believe if we do come back on the growth track, we will do very well, be it in the stock market, the job market. The economy has to kickstart again.
What are your personal concerns? What are you looking for from the budget?
From the budget, I want a roadmap, I want a policy of intent that India is going to come back on the growth path again, and we are going to see a very bright future for our youngsters.
Your sons, you have two sons going to college?
Yes. Two sons who will be going to college, and a very bright future for them, because somehow, you know, you don't want them to keep wanting to go out. You want the cream to stay in India. You want enough job opportunities. There is enough potential in India. Why do we have to keep going out?
That's true. Alka, I was talking to you earlier and you were mentioning your concerns about social security. Yes. What do you expect? Something on this front from the budget?
Yes, because we have to take care of ourselves. And there have to be certain good tax incentives where we are taken care of. An ATD of 20,000 or 15,000 is not sustainable. But ultimately the intent, and which has to be an honest intent of the government, which is what we are looking for. What I want is a dream development and destiny or take-off budget.
A dream development and destiny budget, that's what these ladies here want. But let me ask for ideas for the Modi government from the ladies sitting here. Millennium Mams, Pooja, tell me, what is your expectation or what do you hope to get from the budget?
For me, I love traveling and I'm looking forward that in India there'll be a big, big boom for tourism, as Mr. Modi is pro-tourism and he's developed Gujarat in a very big way. I'm sure India is going to develop. Even the security of the tourists will increase phenomenally, and I don't have to travel abroad every time I want to take a holiday. I can travel in India with the infrastructure, good infrastructure and security as well.
You were also concerned about something which is very close to a lot of people's concerns, and that is the impact that MNREGA is having on people like you. You and your husband run an automobile component factory in Kolkata, right?
Yeah. Actually, because of MNREGA, we are not getting labors. There's a labor shortage. Everybody wants to sit back home and they are getting money. So that is one problem, and one more major problem is the skill development. We don't get skilled labor. There are people who wants to learn, but they are not getting the opportunities to learn. So this MNREGA should be utilized in asset creation. They should be paid when they create something.
And I think, what do you want from this budget?
We want that they should look into this MNREGA system. People should be paid, but poor people should be getting employed, but in a creative way. And I feel it should be there.
And what do you think is going to happen to the stock market after today's budget?
As an investor, I'm always positive, because Modi ji is showing that, and there will be retail people coming in, which were lacking. So for investors like us, I feel the merrier picture is ahead.
What's interesting is all the Millennium Mams over here are referring to Mr. Narendra Modi's budget, when it's actually going to be Mr. Jaitley who is going to make the speech in Parliament in a short while from now. Let me ask for a last word from Sunanda. Sunanda, what will you tell your friends in Millennium Mams to do with their stocks? Buy, sell, wait? What do you want to do?
to do what they have always done, study the company, study the market, and if they have invested wisely, hold. If they see a buying opportunity, buy.
Have you invested wisely, do you think?
I hope so. Time will tell. Time will tell.
Okay. So lots of expectations from Mr. Jaitley's budget, budget that will come up in the next few hours. These ladies with me, Millennium Mams, housewives, and also, you know, tracking the economy very, very closely. So words of, you know, expectation from them, great expectations. Now we'll have to see how Mr. Jaitley delivers.
Right, Monideepa, and Millennium Mams not taking a short-term view. They say we don't care about the markets just today, but we hope for a big-term, long-term boost for the economy. Well, let's find out from the other spectrum, the farmers, what they want from this budget. Let's go across to Siddharth. Siddharth, over to you.
Well, Gargi, everybody is anxiously waiting for the budget, which will be tabled in a few moments from now. And we have with us a few farmers in Agar here. Let us speak to them. What are their expectations? Sir, aapse baat kare, aaj budget aane wala hai. Kisano ki kya umeede hain? Aap kya umeed karte hain kisan ke taur pe? Kya hona chahiye?
Hum to sarkar se yehi guzarish karte hain ki is budget mein kisano ko bijli sasti muhaiya karwaye aur कृषि को एक लाभ का धंधा बनाए, एक व्यवसाय के रूप में इसको विकसित करे, ऐसी बजट में प्रावधान रखा जाए। हम तो सरकार से यही उम्मीद करते हैं कि इस तरह का अगर प्रावधान रखा, क्योंकि भारत की 80% आबादी कृषि के ऊपर निर्भर है, इसलिए सरकार को इसको बहुत ज्यादा महत्व देना चाहिए ताकि देश अपना कुछ तरक्की कर सके और किसान को लाभ का धंधा।
आपकी क्या उम्मीदें हैं, क्या करना चाहिए इस बजट में सरकार को ताकि किसानों को फायदा हो?
इस बजट में अगर किसानों को फायदा करना है तो जो आयात होता है उस पर टैक्स बढ़ा देना चाहिए और जो निर्यात होता है उस पर टैक्स कम कर देना चाहिए, तो किसानों को थोड़ा लाभ मिलेगा।
और लाभ मिलेगा,
टैक्स इधर से माल अगर उधर जाएगा तो सरलता से चला जाएगा और उधर से जब आएगा तो थोड़ी कठिनाई पड़ेगी, तो माल कम आएगा तो भारत में संतुलन बन जाएगा। और
So quite a valid point he's trying to say, that whatever is being imported, on that duty should be increased so that farmers here who are growing the same crop should not suffer. We have one more farmer with us, let us speak to him. Sir, aapke hisab se kya kya hona chahiye budget mein kisanon ke liye is baar?
Kisanon ke liye ek to khad aur beej gunavatta ka mile aur kam rate mein mile, ये होना चाहिए। और साथ ही जो क्या है कि भारत एक कृषि प्रधान देश है और कृषि का अगर अच्छा तरीके से अगर इसको लेंगे तो भारत का भी विकास होगा और किसानों का भी विकास होगा।
नरेंद्र मोदी ने बजट पेश होने से पहले एक इंडिकेशन दिया था कि जो कड़वी दवाई की तरह भी कुछ चीजें आएंगी। हम जो बातें कर रहे हैं बहुत ही पॉजिटिव और अच्छी बातें कर रहे हैं, लेकिन क्या उसके लिए भी किसान तैयार है अगर कुछ दिक्कतें या कुछ कठिन निर्णय लिया जाता है इस बजट में? तो
हमें विश्वास है कि मोदी सरकार पहली बार बनी है और पहली बार जो है किसानों के हित में निश्चित रूप से का पूरा ध्यान रखते हुए काम करेगा। और निश्चित रूप से वो भी जानते हैं कि भारत एक कृषि प्रधान देश है और किसानों की हालत सुधरे और उनको कम रेट पे दवाई खाद बीज वगैरह सब उपलब्ध हो।
So Gargi, there you have it, people here, you know, though Narendra Modi had warned that there may be a bitter pill that they should expect, but despite all of that, the farmers here are quite optimistic that Narendra Modi's government, Mr. Jaitley's budget, will have a lot of positive things for the farmers in the days to come. Back to you.
All right, Siddharth, so expectations from farmers there in Madhya Pradesh. But let's find out what entrepreneurs want from this budget. Let's go across to Radhika, who joins us from Bangalore. Over to you, Radhika.
Thanks, Gargi. We're coming to you from a coffee shop in Koramangala area in Bangalore, easily a big counterpart to Whitefield, which is the IT, or rather the Valley, as it is called in the globe. Let me go across to these young entrepreneurs. What is your suggestion, demand, expectation from this budget?
Hey, I'm Akash. I run a small firm called C42 Engineering. The biggest problem people are going to face while creating $1 billion companies in India is accepting money from abroad. Today it's extremely difficult to get money from anywhere but India, and we had to actually go across and set up a US subsidiary just to collect money, right? Like just to accept $10, $5 payments, and we're not talking about FDIs over here. Second bigger problem is recurring payments. Today, because of OTP, which I understand is a security feature.
One-time password.
Yeah, one-time password, which is a good security feature, but what's happening is most of the companies are not able to collect money because of that. We have a lot of drop-off rates, which means the total number of customer base reduces easily by 30 to 40% purely because of this.
Sure.
You remove that and you will see a massive flourishing in the smaller scale lifestyle businesses coming up.
Sure. As a customer though, I might be on the other side of the fence. Raghu, what is your expectation?
See, from the government side, what we really want is a single window clearance for all the regulatory approvals, right? And the government has to be much more engaged with startups by essentially having a fund to invest in startups. The current way to do it is to raise debt from banks, which is a challenging bit. If the government starts investing in startups, I think we should be, all the startups combined together should probably solve the unemployment problem in India. That's one. The second thing is government should start investing in better infrastructure in across all the cities. In Bangalore, we are lucky because we get good infrastructure here. But in other cities, wherever we go, wherever we have to set up offices, first we figure out where fiber optic cables are. Yeah. Then we start searching for office spaces there. It's not where you find an office and then you get a fiber optic facility over there.
Yes. So perhaps decentralize and make sure that infrastructure is built across and not just in one particular area. Ask any Bangalorean what he wants from the budget and he'll say public Wi-Fi as opposed to what farmers perhaps were asking from Madhya Pradesh. But the common sentiment here, of course, the government has been promising startup village in places like Kochi, in Bangalore, in Chennai, where there is a single window option where one person who has a bright, brilliant idea can just get started and everything else can be sorted. Things like legal advice, maybe accountancy help, someone who can take care of administration. But that so far has been in the freezer. Let that be out, they say. Let there be single window clearances where startups can be encouraged, because these are young entrepreneurs. Cherian, for example, is all of 29, and as a co-founder of something like Cucumber Town, he has several millions of users who are using that particular website. So these are ideas which are extremely interesting, innovative, which are generating employment, generating revenue. So perhaps time to focus on startups across the country.